And now, time for weekly show with a passionate India lover, chairman of ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media. Get ready for loving sharing from physician, philanthropist, publisher, and India advocate in this week with Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh. Welcome to This Week with Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh. And Dr. Sudhir Parikh, I welcome you. With folded hands, I convey my namaskar to you. And whole India was waiting for something to happen in response to Pulwama attack. The way things have unfolded, what we have seen, what we have heard, how do you feel?
Well, to start with, let me, on behalf of Indian American community and all the NRIs outside India, I would like to salute our Jawans, as well as I would like to congratulate our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Bhai Modi and his determined effort to punish and make India safe.
So with that congratulations, let's go slightly into the details of the potential options which were available. And you have yourself attended a lot of demonstrations and candlelight vigil here in New Jersey. The kind of expectations that people had from Government of India here as well as in India, do you think the reply is befitting?
I think reply was befitting. It's very measured. It's very timely. And it's very kind of defensive, because what I understand from the Secretary of MEA, that they had some information that these terrorists are planning some more attacks on India in different locations, and they could identify the terrorist location where they were training, where they were getting ready. So I think this is really a great, perfect, measured, and calibrated response, where we are really, even though we crossed the LOC, we did not cross the LOC, because this is a way we have good argument that what we did is in defense of anticipated multiple terrorist attack in near future.
And let's talk about international community's response. I believe even before this was planned and the day was chosen, probably Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Indian government was in close contact with America, France and several other countries.
Yes, and I think everyone, international diplomatic circle and all the governments, they all agree that this was very measured in self-defense, and it's a appropriate response to what happened 2 weeks ago.
And Dr. Shah, just staying towards the emotional side of Indians, when they feel that intrusion happens, they come and kill innocent people and we do nothing, which happened a couple of times. So this makes some significant change in the morale of common Indian citizens.
Yes, of course, it made all the Indian citizen and Indian American outside India very proud and very satisfied, because they all there is some closer to it, and this is a perfect way of closing without escalating whole situation between two countries, and without having much collateral, without having any collateral damage to the innocent civilians. This is a perfect response, and I must congratulate and I must salute our Prime Minister for his wisdom, his judgment, and his vision.
So as you have also expressed your special respect, I would say, for the vision of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And we just witnessed an important landmark unveiling or inauguration of National War Memorial in India at prime location in Delhi. You must have seen the images. It's a huge campus.
I think it was kind of overdue, because we must remember all the jawans who protect us, who die for us, who really sacrifice their life for us, should be remembered forever. And this jawan's memorial is a great idea. Just like example in Washington DC, we have Vietnam War Memorial, Korean War Memorial.
Right.
That has to be there because history has to be remembered. Any country, any culture, person has to appreciate it when they work for the people of the country. And I'm really thank you, Prime Minister Modi and his government, to inaugurating this excellent and looks like a very great design.
Absolutely.
War memorial. And I'm sure that our young children, young adults will go there and they will remember and they will learn, and that's how you continue your culture, history in the future by looking at the history from the back.
Absolutely.
Or past.
And he has also demonstrated how someone with character, when he leads the nation, everybody is energized and inspired. So we'll come back to India, but let's go to the response of Pakistan. Pakistan government, as happens most of the time, has denied that anything of this nature has taken place. And talk to me a little bit about how do you perceive the potential reaction from Pakistan?
Well, I mean, I'm hoping, I'm the very optimistic person. I'm hoping that because of this attack or this our action was very measured, very calibrated, very in defense. I mean, in self defense. I'm sure that my guess or my bet is that probably Pakistan will just do rhetoric talk, and I don't think they will do anything counterattack, and everything will hopefully stop here.
Mm. So I just bring to your attention, just 4 days ago, Prime Minister of Pakistan in his statement was using threatening tone that
right.
If India takes any action, we won't think, we'll retaliate. And then just a day ago, the statement was that Prime Minister Modi, let us give peace a chance. So there was already a shift in the way he was approaching the whole scenario.
No, because right now what I understand from the expert, military expert and defense expert, international and national, that Pakistan is not in position economically to sustain any war. Plus, Pakistan military is also probably is not in a great shape right now. That was that according to the expert, quote unquote. So I think that's why my hope is that nothing is going to happen, counter reaction to what happened yesterday. And that's the best for both the countries. We taught them a lesson. We destroyed the base where all the terrorists was kind of breeding. And I think that probably they will think twice in the future before they do something like this.
Mm-hmm.
In Pulwama.
Absolutely. And Dr. Sudhir Parikh, before we conclude today's show, I also want you to share your views on another important landmark unveiling of the biggest Srimad Bhagavad Gita at SCON Temple in Delhi by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Symbolically, what do you think it suggests?
No, it suggests that when only any culture or any heritage or any history only can continue if you go back to your roots. And Srimad Bhagavad Gita is our roots of the Hinduism, roots of our India. And it's all other spiritual books, directly or indirectly, came from this Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So inauguration of the large scale book or giant, I mean, life size Gita, it's a great service and great it's a great vision of Prime Minister, and what he's telling the young generation that stick to your roots, stick to your heritage, stick to your culture, and follow the preaching of the Gita, and you will be successful in the future.
Mm. And as we conclude, share how Srimad Bhagavad has helped you find your way, and any parting words for our viewers.
Well, I always believe that to success, and I really practice myself for many years, that always be honest, always be helpful without any expectation from the others. If you do that, you always be happy, and you always be respected, and always remember, always you respect other, then you get a similar respect back to you. So that's my
wonderful
life.
Absolutely. The mantra is respect, and you get respected. And I want to thank, and any thought as we conclude this show directly for our viewers.
Well, I mean, my dear friends of Indian American living in America, as well as all friends in India, I think we must salute our Prime Minister for his very decisive action, as well as we must salute our jawans who took part, or pilots who took part in this operation, because of them, today we are safe and our democracy is thriving. Okay, then let's meet again next week. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat Mata, bye bye.